ओमज्ञानतिमिरन्धस्य ज्ञानञ्जनशलाखया चक्षुरुन्मीलितं येन तस्मै श्रीगुरवे नमः नमो विष्णुपादाय कृष्णपृष्ठाय भूतले श्रीमते भक्तिवेदान्तस्वामिनिति नामिने नमस्ते सारस्वते देवे गौरवाणी प्रचारिणे निर्विशेषा शून्यवादी पाश्चात्यदेशतारिणे जय श्री कृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभु नित्यानंद श्री अद्वैत गदाधर श्रीवासादी गौर भक्तवृंद हरे कृष्णा कृष्ण कृष्ण हरे 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 राम 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 हरे हरे सो प्रभुपाद इज एक्सप्लेनिंग टू वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट क्वालिटीज ऑफ द लॉर्ड towards his devotees. So we all understand that actually the Lord, he is called Bhakta Vatsala, very very dear to his devotees, and devotees are very dear to him. All these different verses the Lord has been telling us about his understanding, his position about the devotees, which his servants fail to understand. Shri Shri Krishna Balaram Kiragaya. The Lord is saying, these servants of mine have transgressed against you, not knowing the mind of their master. They are not knowing, they could not understand how dear the devotees are to the Supreme Lord. So, actually the devotees are very very dear to the Lord. So that is one case. Another is, when the two doormen, because they are also his devotees, they are cursed, the Lord wants, he is requesting on the behalf of his two doormen that please, even though they do deserve to be punished, but kindly give me a favor that their punishment may be reduced. They should not be staying back away from me for a very long time. Let them come back as early as possible back to Vaikuntha. So Prabhupada says, these are two very important qualities of the Lord. The Lord is very anxious for his devotees, and the Lord is very kind to his devotees. So we can see here very clearly these two qualities of the Lord being expounded in this incident. Another very important thing which Prabhupada mentions in this purport is, this incident proves very clearly, once you go back to Godhead, you will not fall down. Once you are back into the spiritual world, you will not fall down. Because the relationship between the devotee and the Lord is so sweet, there is no possibility that the living entity would forego that relationship and come back to this material world, even though he has that independence. He will not misuse his independence once again. Realizing the intimate relationship the Lord has for his devotees. So this is another important point Prabhupada says, once you are back to Godhead, you will not fall down. The Lord also gives that assurance, name bhakta pranashyati. This is the assurance given by the Lord, my devotees will never perish. Maybe sometimes as Prabhupada is saying here, it was just an accident. Otherwise, they would not fall down. It was just by accident, not understanding the mind of their master, Jaya and Vijaya had to come to this material world. But the Lord is very kind. He is requesting these sages that see to it, they come back very early. This is the third point which Prabhupada makes in this purport. Another very important point which Prabhupada is making in today's purport is about, there is no question of any conflict arising between devotees and the Lord. That there is no possibility. But sometimes there is a possibility that there may be conflicts between the devotees. So sometimes there may be discrepancies, there may be disruption between two devotees. And Prabhupada is explaining here, the consequence of that is the one who is at fault will have to undergo punishment. You see? So it's very important. One should not think that actually now I'm a devotee, so I can do anything and Krishna will excuse me. I am chanting the holy name of the Lord, so it does not matter even if I criticize, even if I quarrel with other devotees. No. Prabhupada is saying here, the one who is at fault, he will have to bear that punishment, just like Jaya and Vijaya. They had to, the Lord sanctioned that punishment. Whatever was given by, whatever the curse was given by those two sages, the four sages, the four Kumaras. But at the same time, the Lord is very kind. Prabhupada says that punishment will not be very long. So, this is a very important factor when we are dealing with each other in Krishna consciousness. One should remember, one should understand that all devotees are very, very dear to the Lord. The Lord cannot expect, does not expect that one servant of His criticizes, disrupts, or there are discrepancies with another servant of the Lord. This is very painful to the Lord. There was, Prabhupada explains a very important principle, how to deal with devotees. Whenever there is conflict between the devotees, whenever there is some disruption between the devotees, how we can deal with each other? What should be our consciousness? So there was one devotee, we all know, Tamal Krishna Goswami. So when he was in Mayapur, in India, he had taken permission from Prabhupada. So there were two types of cooking done, basically. Very fine rice was offered to the deities and then as a prasadam it was given to Prabhupada. And then there was another quality of rice, little harsh it was, little, you know, just like dappa rice we call it, fat rice. And to the devotees, that is what it was served, because this fine rice was not available in good quantity in Mayapur at that time. You know, it was a very remote kind of area. It was not like Calcutta city or where different varieties of rices are available. So the cooks, they used to, you know, cook very fine rice for Prabhupada. So Tamal Krishna Goswami, somehow he felt very uncomfortable by eating that rice. He was not used to all these things. So he went to Prabhupada and he took permission that, Prabhupada, whatever remnants is left from your plate, you know, please give me permission, I will take it. So Prabhupada gave that permission that okay, you can take it. And then other devotees felt very dissatisfied. Even though other devotees, they did not complain. They were eating whatever was available. But still they had a complaint. So they also went to Prabhupada and they also complained. That Prabhupada, we also would like to have your remnant. Why we should be deprived of your remnant? Why Tamal Krishna Goswami, because he is your personal servant, he should partake and take away the whole, whatever is left from your plate. Isn't it? So, now Prabhupada had to deal with, one has already taken permission to partake whatever is left, and then others also should not be deprived of Prabhupada's mercy. So as we read in one of the earlier classes, actually Vedic literature explains, Chaitanya Charitamrita explains, when the bhoga is offered to the Lord, it is called as Mahaprasada. The remnants of the Lord is called Mahaprasada. It's not ordinary. But when the same Mahaprasadam is honored by a pure devotee of the Lord, those remnants becomes Maha Maha Prasadam. When they are honored by pure devotee of the Lord. So, all the devotees wanted that mercy of Prabhupada, whatever was left after Prabhupada had partaken the Prasadam. So, then Prabhupada called all his devotees and then he gave his verdict. He said, no doubt, I have given you permission that you can partake my whatever is left over in the plate. But at the same time, other devotees cannot be deprived. So then Prabhupada, he gave a very important principle. He said, just because one is a direct servant of the spiritual master and another is not a direct servant of the spiritual master, one who is direct servant should not become proud and think that actually he is offering more valuable service to the spiritual master. And he should not deride the position of other devotees. Rather, Prabhupada said, one who thinks that I am not a direct servant of my spiritual master of Krishna, I am servant of the servant of the servant of the servant. Prabhupada says, actually he is more advanced in his understanding. But one who is thinking that I am the direct servant, he is actually not a very advanced devotee. So then Prabhupada gave the example that actually this should be the consciousness of the devotees. So he gave the example that in Mayapur there are so many pilgrims who come. And when the pilgrims are walking on the road doing parikrama, so one of the pilgrims, he thinks that without taking the dust of other devotees, it is very difficult to advance in Krishna consciousness. So he goes and he falls flat before the Vaishnavas and he tries to take their dust. And whereas the other Vaishnava to whose feet he is trying to fall down, he is getting away. He is thinking, what are you doing? I am not a great Vaishnava. I am just trying to be a devotee. I am an ordinary man. So Prabhupada says, this should be the consciousness of the devotees. Where one understands, without taking the mercy of other Vaishnavas, it is not possible to advance in devotional service. And at the same time, the devotee should not think himself to be something great. He should think, I am just trying to be a devotee. I am not some great Vaishnava. So Prabhupada said, if one keeps this understanding in his heart always, there will be no conflict between the devotees. When one maintains this humble position, then there are no conflicts. Otherwise, the moment we start thinking, I am advanced devotee, I am important devotee, my position is better, my service is better, I am doing direct service, somebody is doing indirect service. The moment this pride comes, actually we are not very advanced in our devotional understanding. So, this is a very important principle. In fact, Prabhupada said so much that just by the external activities of other devotees, one should not judge their consciousness. It so happened that when Prabhupada, he went to America in New York temple. So after he returned from India, he saw that lot of criticism is going on between devotees. So few devotees were criticizing other devotees, some devotees were criticizing some other devotees. So then Prabhupada called all of them and he said that just by external, one should not judge the consciousness of other devotees and start criticizing them. And then he told a very important story, very interesting story. So this is actually story told by Prabhupada, very essential for devotees to understand that how just by externals of other devotees, one should not criticize, one should not find faults in services or in the personality of other devotees. So Prabhupada, he said, there was a place where one Brahmana used to live. Every day he would sit beside his window and he would be reading Bhagavad Gita. And right across his street, there used to live one prostitute who would also stand on the window side, sometimes looking at the Brahmana and sometimes looking in the street. So this was daily affair. This Brahmana, he would go and sit by the window and he would be taking Bhagavad Gita, going through it and sometimes glancing at the other side. And on the other side, there used to be that prostitute and she would be standing by the side of the window, looking at the customers who are coming and sometimes glancing at the Brahmana. So then Prabhupada explains, one fine day, Brahmana's time was over. And when Brahmana's time was over and when he was giving up this body, Yamaraj came to take him. So then he was very annoyed. He said, what is this? Whole lifetime I have been a Brahmana and Yamaraj has come for me. And at the same time, the prostitute was also leaving the body. So Vishnu Dutas came for the prostitute. So he was completely surprised that what is this? He said, some mistake is there. I think you should be going, Yamaraj should go there and Vishnu Duta should come here. It should be exchange offer. By mistake they would have changed their place. So Yamaduta said, no sir, it is not a mistake. We have come to the right place. And then the Yamadutas explained. He said, whole day you were sitting near the window, but your only business was sense gratification, looking at the prostitute and what she is doing. You were not reading Bhagavad Gita. Your consciousness was absorbed in how this prostitute is lucky, she is enjoying so much. You're only contemplating about that. Whereas the prostitute, even though she was in that business, she was always conscious of her dirty position and she was always thinking you to be fortunate who was reading Bhagavad Gita. And she was always thinking, when will I give up this profession and become like this Brahmana and take up to the devotional service of the Lord. Her consciousness was always absorbed in that sense to become a devotee of the Lord. You see? So by this simple incident, by the simple story, Prabhupada wanted to convey to the devotees that actually it can be a great mistake that sometimes we try to judge the devotees from the externals. And it is not our business. It is not our business to find faults, to find discrepancies in other devotees. So, this is very important to understand that actually if while doing our devotional service there are such disruptions, such discrepancies, such kind of misunderstanding, misjudgments, fault finding, all these things if we are doing, then we should know that actually definitely without fail there will be punishment. Just like here we are seeing, not understanding the mind of their Lord, the two doorkeepers, they had disrespected the four great sages, not understanding how dear the Brahmanas and the Vaishnavas are to the Supreme Lord. So they had to undergo that punishment, even though very kindly the Lord had reduced their punishment, that he is requesting on their behalf, on the behalf of the two doorkeepers, that kindly see to it that these two personal servant of mine, they don't remain too long in the material world and they can come back to me as early as possible. So this is what they are requesting. So Prabhupada is saying here, it is to be assumed that there is no possibility of a misunderstanding between the Lord and the devotees. But when there are discrepancies or disruption between one devotee and another, one has to suffer the consequences, although that suffering is temporary. So actually, that is the greatness of the Lord. That is the kindness of the Lord, that sometimes even though his devotees are punished, the Supreme Lord is so kind, he is requesting other devotees on their behalf that please see to it that they come back as early as possible. So this is actually the great affection between the Lord and his devotees. Prabhupada says it is just like the Supreme Father and the Son. That sometimes even though the son has grown, he has gone crazy, he leaves his father, he does not understand what his father is wishing for him. Sometimes he misunderstands and leaves his father and goes away. But the father, even though the son has gone away, is always thinking about to bring back his son. So Prabhupada says, that is the position of the Supreme Lord. Even in the material world we can see. So how much more affectionate the Supreme Lord is towards his pure devotees, we can understand. That is why not only the Supreme Lord, even though the material world is created, so that the living entities, they can try to fulfill their desires to be independent of the Lord, in spite of this, the Lord has made wonderful arrangements so that the living entities can come back very quickly back to Godhead. This is the anxiety of the Supreme Lord. He is very anxious. Prabhupada says the Lord is more anxious than we are. We are not very anxious to go back to Godhead. The Lord is more anxious than us to bring us back to Godhead. That's why actually we can appreciate this quality of the Lord. What does he do? In spite of creating this world to fulfill our desire to be independent of the Lord personally descends. The Lord personally comes now and then Himself personally comes. Not only he personally comes, the Lord has made an arrangement, I will be available always with you. In the form of Paramatma, the Lord expands himself. He comes down to this material world. He has nothing to do with the material world. He doesn't want to enjoy. We are in an enjoying spirit. But the Lord is very, very kind. He helps us in our enjoyment as Paramatma. And the moment the living entity desires, understands the reality that actually being away from the Lord, I cannot be happy, at that very moment, the Lord takes charge of the devotee. Prabhupada used to say, you take one step, the Lord takes 100 steps towards you, because he is more anxious than you. So the Lord is sitting in the Paramatma, as a Paramatma in the heart. Then what happens? The moment you have a desire, immediately the Lord arranges. He guides you. See how much the Lord does? The moment you become little sincere to go back to Godhead, as Chaitya Guru, he will guide you to external Guru. So he makes another arrangement. Not only he guides as a Paramatma from the heart, he will guide us to the external spiritual master so that we can surrender, we can take advantage. Not only that, the Supreme Lord has arranged for all Vedic literature. The Lord personally comes down, speak Bhagavad Gita. Through his devotees, he makes an arrangement. You take the position of conditioned soul. He's telling Arjuna, you take the position of conditioned soul. Actually, Arjuna is Nitya Siddha. He's always eternal associate of the Lord. But the Lord makes this arrangement. You take the position of conditioned soul. Be in problem. Then I will give you discourse. I will give you solution. You can come back to me. So that this will serve as an example how the conditioned soul can come back to me. So being very compassionate, the Lord gives these Vedic literatures to the living entities. So we can see, this is the kindness, this is the anxiety of the Lord. And that is why anyone who fulfills this anxiety of the Lord, anyone who takes this anxiety of the Lord to deliver the living entity back to Godhead, he becomes a very, very dear servant of the Lord. That is what Krishna explains in Bhagavad Gita. No one is more dearer than the person who brings back the living entity back to Godhead by giving the message of Bhagavad Gita. So we'll stop with this. Grantha Srimad Bhagavatam ki Jagat Guru Srila Prabhupada ki.